Recently, a thought crossed my mind about Billy Joel's famous song, "We Didn't Start the Fire," and how it might sound if written today. Instead of Lawrence of Arabia, British Beatlemania, Old Miss John Glenn, Liston B. Patterson, Pope Paul Malcolm X, British politician sex, JFK blown away. What else do I have to say? We didn't start the fire. It was always burning since the world returned. And the 2021 version would go,
coronavirus, climate crisis, trade wars, fighting ISIS, Bitcoin, GameStop, there go all our stocks, George Floyd, BLM, Joe Biden back again, Donald Trump, QAnon, storm the freaking Capitol.
But seriously, it seems like every week there's another riot, shooting, or high-profile scandal. It begs the question, is the fire that Billy Joel sang about burning the brightest it ever has? Is American society more tumultuous and energized than ever before? And as a soon-to-be college grad, should I be scared or inspired by everything? Thing is, considering my young age and the hyperdrama of modern media, I can't really answer these questions for myself. So I decided to embark on a journey to simply get some answers. I would turn to the old heads in my life, with all their wisdom, to see what they had to say about the state of our nation. First up, my grandfather Larry.
I never felt the way I do now.
Wow,
In my entire 94 years.
Right.
I never felt like I do now.
Uh-huh.
Now, maybe that's partly because of my age, but I don't think so. I think I've got a pretty good handle on my cognition. Of course, when I was a teenager and my parents talked about what was going on in Europe,
right,
with the suffering of the Jews, I felt that it was a very cruel world, but that turned into the World War II, where I had a pretty strong certainty that I was on the right side and that American democracy was on the right side and that we were fighting a good war and values weren't questioned.
Right.
So this time is unique.
And it feels unique even in comparison to like let's say the 60s.
Vietnam started a new, that's when my certainty started to change.
Mm-hmm.
My certainty that there was, America was on the right track. That's when I started to question the establishment.
Mm-hmm.
and its ability to deal with the challenges of the country.
So you can't really argue with that. I mean, the man was born in 1926 and is well educated too. He must know what he's talking about. But I still was not quite convinced. Yes, there's a serious lack of unity right now, but there's no way this is the most disorderly things have been since the Great Depression, and even the Civil War. Right? Maybe not. I called each of my parents, and they too offered up conclusions similar to my grandfather's. My dad pointed out that everyone seems so fed up about something these days, and my mom pointed out how much inter-class conflict there is. People of the same race and socioeconomic backgrounds hating one another, just if they voted a certain way? These were all good points, yet I still was not satisfied. I wanted to make an informed decision in the end, and my quest wouldn't be over until I heard a dissenting opinion. In a last-ditch effort, I phoned my Uncle Lewis, who's always been one to put apocalyptic rumors into perspective for me. When I asked him how unprecedented today's tumultuousness really is, he said,
So I,
now that I'm older, I would have to say kind of nothing's changed. You know, people, there's been extrajudicial killings forever. There's been people who were murdered for doing nothing wrong forever. And it's the human condition.
The stuff that we're seeing now has happened before, I guess, in your opinion.
I think 100% yes. I'm sorry. I mean, there were lynchings where there was not even any coverage, you know, like
right.
there was no question about what happened. At least now there's a question, you know, about reviewing video.
Right.
Well, but that never happened before. It never even made it to the news before.
Right.
Come on.
And he's right. This week, the police officer that killed George Floyd was officially convicted of murder. But does change towards progressiveness necessarily indicate greater peacefulness and unity? It's hard to say. Anyway, my conversation with Lewis wasn't done. He had one more example from the past to remind me about.
Think of, like, Kent State. Like, students getting killed. But Kent State. American students getting killed by the American National Guard. So do I think these are more tumultuous times? Well.
So, yeah. The Kent State Massacre of 1970. 13 students that were peacefully protesting the Vietnam War were shot by the National Guard, four of which died. In the aftermath, more than 4 million students nationwide would participate in walkouts related to the incident. It makes sense that Billy Joel would write a song about that era. Things really were quite chaotic, eventful, and culturally significant. As for the present, I'm still not sure how this era will measure up in its tumultuousness. But I do know that someday, someone will write a famous song about everything going on around us. I just hope that it's better than mine.